I don't really have a favourite music genre that I actually train to. My coach is normally one that puts on the music. But if I had to say one, I would say quite like emotional chilled music. And the reason why is because when you feel you're so close to something, just having that kind of emotional music in the background kind of makes you train harder and vision your goal whilst you're training. And it kind of makes me train harder, I guess. As a small, short fighter, to get into range and to fight larger opponents, because I feel ever since I started fighting, I was always fighting people a lot bigger than me and taller than me. But your movement has to be strong and on point, because you have to, you're the smaller fighter, so you need to get in and round. So I think movement is one of them. So if you are struggling with that, there's a lot of movement drills and things you can do. So by all means, if you want videos on that or extra help on that, I can provide that for you. Another one would be feints and fakes with what you do. So you've got to feint and then go. You can't just, if you're going to do a blitz, for example, you can't just blitz in a straight line. You need to either use an angle and then go, or feint and then push off. But yeah, I think movement and feints are a big thing. The next thing I would say is commitment. You cannot hesitate. You have to, if you're about to do that blitz or that kick or that punch or that block even, you've got to give it 110%. Remember, you are the shorter person. They've got the reach and they've got the range. So yeah, movement, angles with that, commitment, no hesitation, and feints. So my time kickboxing has helped me massively with my boxing, in terms of movement, head movement, angles, speed, agility, just everything. When I first went to boxing, I had a few people say, oh my God, your movement's insane, this, that and the other. And I was a bit like, what do you mean? Not in an ego way, but in a way because I'm used to moving like that. Like, it's nothing new for me. But obviously in the boxing world, they're not taught the way kickboxers are taught, because obviously we're trying to get away from legs and score the point rather than stay there and fight. So yeah, I think what I've brought from me is definitely the movement, and that's something that I'm going to keep through my boxing career, because it does make me stand out, and it helps a lot with getting in, out, move around. So yeah, the kickboxing journey, I don't regret that at all. It's put me, going through that journey has brought me to where I am today. So yeah, I think kickboxing is a great fundamental and a great tool if you do want to go to any sport, if that's something you want to decide to do in the future, give you the platform for anything. So yeah. So this next one, I was actually gonna say speed if I had to choose one, but I've changed my mind to intelligence. And the reason why I'm gonna say intelligence is because being now on the boxing scene, you do need a good IQ in boxing. You can have the speed, you can have the power, but you don't always need to knock someone out to be successful in boxing. Obviously it's great for the crowd. Speed would be great because you can hit before the other person, for example. But the IQ, you can have someone that's powerful and got speed, but if you've got a better IQ than the other person, it's a win-win. What do I most enjoy and hate about training? So I enjoy the vibe. Where I'm at is great, and just the atmosphere and feeling at home. Yeah, I just love the part of when you're training, I'm training for something. So it helps in the sense of motivation, and training better and doing better. What do I hate? That's a tough one. I don't know what I hate, because I can't actually reel anything off. Nah, I'm gonna have to skip that one, because I don't know what I hate. is that normal? What makes me a good fighter? I would say the hard work, the hours, the dedication, the tears, the sacrifice, my IQ, my intelligence, I think my movement. I just think it does kind of stand out from other people that I've fought before on the boxing scene, as well as kickboxing. But yeah, I would say the love that I have for martial arts all round makes me a good fighter, I think. So I do think I have a role to play in inspiring others, like other females, whether they are boxing now or only just started or want to get involved. It's something I've always wanted to do. I've always wanted to inspire others. And I really hope I can do that. So yeah, I do think I have a role to play. When you are, not saying I've got a big platform, but I'm starting to have a platform because obviously what I've won and kind of where I'm going in my boxing career. I definitely think obviously what you post, what you put out there, my training videos, anything like that, I do think it does play a part. But if anyone who's watching this does want any advice or just anything, like, just give me a message, and I'm here to talk, to message, anything. So my next milestone on my boxing journey, so obviously I was meant to do the elites, which was just before Corona, and that is basically the elite tournament. So if you win that, that's fantastic. But obviously, I think 3 days before my fight, I couldn't participate because it got cancelled. So I'm hoping that is at the end of the year, along with the Haringey Box Cup, which is another big one. And again, the Winter Box Cup as well. I do want to get a few international tournaments in. And there's one in Sweden, I believe, in January. So yeah, there's a lot that I want to get done. And I'm hoping that can be done this year, obviously for the time that's been missed out. But the aim and the goal is to turn pro. That's what I'm working towards. I can see it. I'm visioning it, I'm training hard. But yeah, that is the milestone. I want to turn pro, and eventually when the time comes, I want that world title shot. And yeah, that's what I want to do. I think I can go quite far in boxing in terms of the fights, interviews, just anything like that really. And the reason why I said it is because when you've got like the determination, the motivation, the goal and the vision of where you want to be, I believe anything is achievable. And I've always wanted to be a professional athlete, train all day, every day. So yeah, I do truly believe that I can go far in the sport, and that's what I'm gonna aim to do.